गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ एस जे भातमारे एंड आई एम गिविंग अ सब्जेक्ट हाइड्रोलिक्स 1. टुडे इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ योर सेकंड ईयर ऑफ द फर्स्ट सेमिस्टर. सो वी शैल स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, फंडामेंटल कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द हाइड्रोलिक्स. ओके, इन दैट हाइड्रोलिक्स 1 टोटल 36 लेक्चर्स आर देयर एंड 6 चैप्टर्स आर देयर एंड एवरी चैप्टर हैव 6 लेक्चर्स. ओके, सो देयर आर फंडामेंटल चैप्टर, फर्स्ट चैप्टर, सेकंड चैप्टर इज फ्लूइड स्टैटिक्स, सेकंड चैप्टर इज फ्लूइड काइनेमेटिक्स, थर्ड चैप्टर इज लैमिनार फ्लो, फिफ्थ चैप्टर इज डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस एंड सिमिलिट्यूड एंड सिक्स चैप्टर इज फ्लो मेजरमेंट. ओके, यू ऑलरेडी studied about different types of fluids. In first chapter, properties of fluids or fundamental concepts related to the fluids we are going to discuss about. Okay, so good morning all of you, and we can start this lecture. So properties of fluids, this is the first chapter. Okay, in that we are going to discuss about definition of fluid, fluid properties such as density, specific weight, specific volume, specific gravity, viscosity, compressibility, surface tension, capillarity, vapor pressure, types of fluids, Newtonian and non-Newtonian fluid, continuum and fluid pressure. Okay, so in that chapter, first we studied about what are the contents, introduction, fluid, continuum, fluid properties. Fluid mechanics is the science that deals with the action of forces on fluids at rest as well as in motion. If the fluids are at the rest, the study of them is called fluid statics. If the fluids are in motion where pressure forces are not considered, the study of them is called fluid kinematics. And if the fluid are in motion and the pressure forces are considered, the study of them is called as fluid dynamics. So let's start with the fluid. Fluid matter exists in two states, the solid state and the fluid states. This classification of matter is based on the spacing between different molecules of matter, as well as on the behavior of matter when subjected to stresses. Because molecules in solid state are spaced very closely, solids possesses compactness and rigidity of form, the molecules in the fluid can move more freely within the fluid mass, and therefore the fluids do not possess any rigidity of form. Thus, fluid exists in two forms, liquid and gas. Okay, what's the difference? Liquids flow and take the shape of their container but maintain a constant volume, and gases expand to fill the available volume. Liquids are compressible while the gas are compressible. Liquids are incompressible while the gas are incompressible. Then, what are the fluid properties? There are different properties of fluids such as mass density, specific weight, specific volume, specific gravity, viscosity, surface tension, vapor pressure, capillarity, cavitation, etc. So, we can study it in detail. What are the definitions of these fluid properties? First, mass density or density, it can be denoted by rho. The mass per unit volume is a mass density. Hence, it has unit of kilogram per cubic meter. The mass density of water at 4 degree centigrade is 1000 kg per meter cube, while it is 1.20 kilogram per meter cube for air at 20 degree centigrade at standard pressure. D is equal to mv. Example of density, a quantity of helium gas at 0 degree centigrade with a volume of 4 meter cube has a mass of 0.712 kg at standard atmospheric pressure. Determine the density of this sample of helium gas. As we know, D is equal to m upon V. We can put the values and calculating the D, we can derive or we can calculate D. That is density. Specific weight or weight density, that is lambda. It is the ratio between the weight if a fluid to its volume. It is also weight per unit volume of a fluid. Its unit is Newton per meter cube. Water at 20 degree centigrade has a specific weight of 9.79 kilonewton per meter cube. And the formula is lambda is equal to rho into g. Then specific volume. It is defined as the volume of a fluid occupied by a unit mass or volume per unit mass of a fluid is called as specific volume. Specific volume is equal to volume of the fluid per mass of the fluid. That is L divided by mass of the fluid divided by volume of the fluid, L upon rho. Then specific gravity. The ratio of specific weight of a given liquid to the specific weight of water at a standard reference temperature, 4 degree centigrade, is defined as specific gravity, that is denoted by S. The specific weight of water at atmospheric pressure is 9810 Newton per meter cube. The specific weight of water at atmospheric pressure is 9810 Newton per meter cube. The specific gravity of mercury at 20 degree centigrade is SHG equal to 133 kilonewton per meter cube divided by 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube equal to 13.6. Then viscosity. Different kinds of fluids flow more easily than others. Oil, for example, flow more easily than molasses. This is because molasses has a higher viscosity, which is a measure of resistance to fluid flow inside a pipe or tube. A very thin layer of fluidite near the wall of the tube are motionless because they get caught up in the microscopic ridges of the tube. Layers closer to the center move faster and the fluid shears. The middle layer moves the fastest. As shown in the figure, we can see the viscosity. The more viscous a fluid is, the more the layers want to clinch together and the more it resists the shearing. The resistance is due to the frictional forces between the layers as the slides past one another. Note, there is no friction occurring at the tube surface since the fluid there is essentially still. The friction happens in the fluid and generates heat. The Bernoulli's equation applies to fluids with the negligible viscosity. It is defined as the property of fluid which offers resistance to the movement of one layer of fluid over another adjacent layer of the fluid. The viscosity of a fluid is a measure of its resistance or resistance to deformation. Then we will discuss about Newton's law of viscosity. It states that the shear stress on a fluid element layer is directly proportional to the rate of shear strain. The constant of proportionality is called the coefficient of viscosity. That is, tau is equal to mu into du by dy, where tau is the shear stress, du by dy equal to velocity gradient, and mu is the coefficient of viscosity. Then kinematic viscosity. It is defined as the ratio between the dynamic viscosity and density of the fluid. That is, V is equal to mu upon rho, where divided by meter square divided by kg divided by meters cube, that is equal to meter square per second. वेरिएशन ऑफ विस्कोसिटी विथ टेम्परेचर. लिक्विड्स कोहेजन एंड मोमेंटम ट्रांसफर. विस्कोसिटी डिक्रीजेस एट टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस. रिलेटिवली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ प्रेशर. इनकम्प्रेसिबल. गैसेस ट्रांसफर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर मोमेंटम. विस्कोसिटी इंक्रीजेस एज टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस. विस्कोसिटी इंक्रीजेस एज प्रेशर इंक्रीजेस. देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वेरिएशन ऑफ विस्कोसिटी विथ टेम्परेचर. द ग्राफ शोज द वन लाइन शोज इंक्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजिंग विस्कोसिटी एंड इंक्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर डिक्रीजिंग विस्कोसिटी. ओके दीज आर द डिफरेंट फंडामेंटल कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द फ्लूइड्स सच एज डेंसिटी स्पेसिफिक वेट स्पेसिफिक वॉल्यूम स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी विस्कोसिटी कंप्रेसिबिलिटी सरफेस टेंशन कैपिलरिटी वेपर प्रेशर टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लूइड्स एंड फ्लूइड प्रेशर. वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट इन डिटेल इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू वेरी मच.